Hey, this is Josias. Personalized marketing has loads of advantages, loads of benefits, but sometimes it can be a bit hard to handle. It is a lot more than just hello, first name. You can also use personalization tags to target a bit better your audience, create better messages, and also to get to know a bit more and a lot more about your audience based on their behavior, based on how they interact with your messages, landing pages, websites, videos, emails, SMSs. In this video, I'm going to show you how I use personalization tags to do this, to know a bit more about our leads and customers and also prospects, and also to create messages that are contextualized based on who they are, based on their needs, based on their concerns, and a lot more. All right, let's get into it. Tags are extremely useful. You can use them to create better messages, contextualized messages, which are a lot more effective than general personalized messages. Also, I use them to, and you can use them to profile customers, leads, prospects in an automated way based on what they do. In our case, it is based on what they do through the email marketing campaigns where they click, or if they have registered to a webinar, or if they have subscribed to our platform. We have a personalized video platform, so if they have subscribed, the type of account they have. So there are many advantages, many benefits if you use a tag structure. Also, the way you use them could depend on the marketing automation tool you use, or CRM, email marketing tool, because not every tool uses tags the same way. In my case, we use ActiveCampaign. I have a spreadsheet like this one here, but in my local machine, and in a local server as well, so that I can have everything there, even if I also have it in ActiveCampaign. Let me dive into it. So I'm going to explain in terms of how we use it so that you can then translate it into your own reality based on your product, industry, the type of tool you use, and your specific business goal. Before I get into it, please do not forget to subscribe. Also, give us a like. This will help us a lot, and it will help me serve you better. I copied this structure a couple of years ago. I don't know, 3, 4, 5 years ago. I found it in some kind of blog, someone talking about how to use tags, in that case, in ActiveCampaign, because I was actually looking for a better way to automate messages, automate workflows, automate the profiling, auto-profiling on autopilot, let's say. And I found a lady, I believe it was, that explained how she does it. And it was just perfect. Perfect because of the way my mind, my brain works. Don't just copy this. You need to adapt it to your particular needs. But again, the flexibility options are just many, many benefits. Right, so what we have here, a tab here called tag structure. And here we have tag type, abbreviation, purpose, example. Okay, and this is pretty much so that I can know at a glance what's going on. So this document, it's a live document. I keep it updated, at least from time to time. But I usually keep it updated with all the information that I am actually using in production. In our case, again, through ActiveCampaign, but you could use it for any other platform. In fact, I have done similar things for some of our clients in other platforms. So it's basically a mindset. Let me go over them quickly. Lead magnet, product, prospect, customer, event registered, event attended, event not attended. I'm going to jump just to save time here to campaign, payment methods, concern, sales, CRM management, etc. Concerns, objections are critical, and you can use them to create better targeted messages, more contextualized messages based on what your concerns are. Jump to goal, ask. I'll explain more about it later. You'll find the video here somewhere. And with this particular thing here, customers, leads, and prospects automatically profile themselves by simply clicking. And all we do is ask. Extremely useful. Use it to automatically segment your audience and to retrieve customer data in a super useful, frictionless way. User persona and account activation. All right, so here then I have the abbreviation. This is simply for management purposes. And you'll see how in this example here. Example, type, tag type, lead magnet, purpose, track which lead magnet they downloaded. So we have different lead magnets across our digital properties, especially blog post, and I want to know which lead magnet converts, because that will also tell me a bit more about your interest, concerns. So here you have an example, lead magnet LM tag micro-segmentation with Hugo English. So this is basically a webinar we had maybe about 2 years ago. The link is also here in this video, and about personalization, micro-segmentation, segmentation, the difference between all those terms. So take a look at it. Another example here would be, for example, concern, a record of sales concerns. In this case, the concern might be pricing. So let me dive into it more in a more specific way. Let's go with user persona. Again, here in the tag structure, going back, we have user persona, and it helps me identify the software user persona to create better marketing campaigns and drive more conversions. And in this case, we have an example, user persona agency. So if we come here, I have one specific tab for each tag type, and there I'll have different tags that are associated to that particular tag type. So in this case, we have user persona, and in our case, common user personas, there are more, obviously, but the common ones in this case are marketer, agency, developer, designer, general, that's because there are more, and we cannot cover all of them, and operations. Why? Because these are the common customers and leads and prospects we speak with, or just people that use our software, our personalized video marketing software. By the way, check it out, personal.com with an I. All right, so another one here, ask. I love this one, and I see here that sadly it's not updated, but ask is, again, related to the video I told you about earlier. It talks about how to automatically segment your audience, or even better, how they can segment themselves using the ask method. So I don't know, maybe 2-3 years ago, I started investigating about better ways to gather customer data. And I learned about the ask method, understood how to apply it, and I've been using it since then. Super useful. In this case, ask, these are questions we ask them, and these are their answers. So these are usually questions where these leads have clicked. If they click, they're automatically tagged. And this is amazing because they are giving us information, real information, and we can use this information to better serve them and to convert faster. So an example, ask, I'm an agency and need more information for a project. So this is a lead that has registered, as an example, and received an email. And in that email, the lead will find different questions. All the lead has to do is to click there. And in this case, we don't know yet if it is an agency, or if it is someone related to operations, if it is a designer, or if it is a marketer, or if it is a brand, customer experience manager, we don't know that yet. So the lead in this case clicks in the option, I am an agency and need more information for a project. And this is amazing because this is probably an agency telling us, letting us know that they are working on a project for a client. So they are looking for a solution, they are shopping around in the market for a solution that they want to use for a specific project for a client. So again, amazing, because we can use this information to send them specific messages tailored to agencies. Another example here is lead type. As I can see here, this is not updated, so shame on me. Lead type could be a partner, it could be just a normal user, it could be an agency that is not a partner. We have certified partners. So there are many different types of leads. Account type, these are the different accounts in our system. So we have account type, 14 days trial. And this is good because, for example, we use this to know if an account has upgraded or downgraded so that we can send different messages to that person based on the type of account they have in the system. User type, so it could be a trial user, as you can see here. User type, paid, an active account. It could be a paid client, but it's inactive. Or it could be a partner with an active account, or a partner with an inactive account. Buying cycle, awareness, consideration, purchase, action. I love this one. So for example, not engaged with content. This person has read a case study. This individual has requested a quote, or this person here has requested a call, in this case with me, for example, or has selected a plan, has watched a video, has downloaded content, has subscribed to a yearly plan. Account activation, even more options here. Account activation, It could be this person hasn't activated the account yet, or yes, has activated the account. Paying method, it could be Stripe, PayPal, bank transfer, TransferWise. I mean, as many scenarios as you need. Concerns, I have actually some here in Spanish, it might be for Spanish related campaigns. So, sin tiempo, no time. Otras implementaciones, they are busy with other things. Sin presupuesto, but si quiero, we don't have the budget, but we still want to do this. Personalización no es importante, personalization is not that important for us. Sin presupuesto y no quiero, which is, we don't have the budget and we don't want to buy. As you can see, there are many ways you can use this in your marketing. Simply find the best way for you guys to contextualize these tags based on your needs so that you can create messages that are highly relevant to each individual and also so that you can automatically and on the fly know more about your customers to serve them better, convert more and faster. I hope you found this useful. Take care. See you later. Do not forget to subscribe. Bye.